Yes, 1 Samuel chapter 16. The Bible says, and it came to pass when they were come that he looked on Eliab and said, surely, you know, Eliab was the first son of Jesse. Yes, and according to Bible, he's a very tall, very handsome, very gigantic. And so he defeats the king. Hallelujah. And so the moment Samuel saw him, Samuel in the eyes of a man, felt, oh, come on, this is the son, oh, this is the next king of Israel. Because the man looks like a king. He's a giant. Hallelujah. And he's nice. And he's presentable. And so in the eyes of Samuel, he feels that he should be the next king of Israel. Amen. And so Bible says that, and it came to pass when they were come that he looked on Eliab when the sons were coming. And he said, surely the Lord's anointed is before him. Hallelujah. So someone said, come on, this is the guy that I need to anoint. And Bible says in verse 7 that, but the Lord said unto Samuel, look not on his word, his countenance. Look not on his appearance or on the height of his stature. Don't look at his height. Don't look at his appearance. Amen. Because I have refused him. For the Lord seeth not as what? Man does what? Seeth. For man looketh on the outward appearance, but the Lord looketh on the what? The heart. Hallelujah. Man looks on the outward, but God looks on the heart. Man looks at the outward appearance. And so when we come to God, or anytime you come to God, I am not saying that appearance is wrong. No, it's very important. It is not right to just wear anything and come to God or come to the midst of people. No, you cannot just wear anything. It is good to dress decent. It is good to dress nice. It is good to dress appropriate, which is also equally important. Hallelujah. But then God does not look at the outward appearance of man. But God looks at the heart. God looks at where? Oh, God looks at where? The heart of man. And so, now that we are gathered here, God is not looking at your beauty. God is not looking at your sitting position. God is not looking at the way you're looking so nice. And you have powdered and polished and done your hair very nice, and you are wearing the smartest dress and the nice shoe and the latest whatever. God is not interested in that. He is interested in your heart. So as we are seated here, God is interested in our heart. And you see, I just got it that anytime we come to God, everyone has a condition of heart. Amen. Every one of us, somebody may be so joyful. Hearts might be full of joy because you have heard good news, or something you are expecting has come to pass, or you just went to check you just slotted in your bank pass, and some things you saw in your accounts, you never dreamt you see it, so you are happy. Hallelujah. Or somebody just called you and gave you good news, or something good happened to you, so you have come to church, but you are so excited. Hallelujah. Somebody too might have come and the person is disturbed, and so their heart is full of disturbing issues. Amen. Somebody too might have come and the person is their heart is full of unnecessary issues. Say unnecessary. Because there are some things that are unnecessary that you can allow them to disturb you and fill your heart. But what I want to say is that whether you are joyful, whether you are disturbed, or whether you are filled with unnecessary issues in your heart, they are not all important when you come to God. Say, they are not important. Hallelujah. They are not important when we gather in the presence of God. God is not interested. Yes, He's. Bible says that He wish above all things that we will prosper and be in good health, even as our soul prospering. God takes pleasure in the prosperity of His children. And so when things are good for you and you are happy, God is happy. But He's not interested. manifested in need when you are excited and you come to him and your heart is already filled and you are full of excitement and you are full of joy. So whatever is happening in his presence, your mind is not there. You are thinking about the thing that has happened to you. And so because of excitement, your mind is not on God. Am I talking to someone?
Yes.
Hallelujah. You are so excited that even as you are seated and we are praying and we are singing and the word of God is coming, you are thinking about your excitement, the good news you have. It is not important to God. Bible says that when you come to him, you should expect.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And so God only fills empty vessels. Can you tell somebody for me? I said, God fills what? Oh, speak to me. God fills what? God fills what? God fills what? So when you come to God, you need to empty your heart. I hope I'm talking to someone. And so it can happen that for a whole month, you can go to church, you don't gain anything. You don't get anything, you don't interact with God, you don't do anything with God. Why? Because your heart is already full. And whenever you are full, he doesn't come in. Hallelujah. He always wants to what? Feel emptiness. When you are empty, then he comes into feeling. I am praying that I'm not going to talk for long, but I'm praying that the little I will tell you, God will water it with the Spirit, and it will keep ringing, and it will enlighten the eyes of your understanding, so you will understand God better. So from today, when you come to church, it wouldn't be like you are coming to satisfy someone. It wouldn't be like you are coming because you have to come, but if you are coming because you want to gain from God. You are coming because you want something from God. Amen.
Amen.
Matthew chapter 16. Let's go there quickly. Matthew chapter 16. Let's read some few scriptures. Matthew chapter 16, verse 25. Jesus said something there. Matthew 16:25. I am there. I'll read. It says, for whosoever will save his life shall lose it. And whosoever will lose his life for my sake shall find it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
For whosoever will save his life, if you decide to keep it, he will watch you to keep it. But the moment you open up and you say, Lord, take it, it is for you, it will come in. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Am I talking to someone? Amen. And so you must always empty your heart when you come to God. Now, what I'm talking about is not only when you come to church. What I'm talking about is any time you go to God, empty your heart. Let the Lord know, God, this is me coming. I need you. Am I talking to someone? Hallelujah. That is why prophetically in the book of 2 Kings chapter 4, when the woman, the widow, whose husband died because he owed, and he came for him, her sons, to go and serve as bondmen or servants. That is why, prophetically, when she went to the prophet asked her, what do you have? And when she told the prophet what she had, the prophet said, go and borrow vessels. And if you realize, in verse 3, Bible says the prophet told her, borrow empty vessels. And don't borrow a few. And you realize that when the prophet told her, take it into the room and pour the oil. And when you pour the oil and they are full, pour into another one. Pour into others. Pour. And he said, don't borrow a few. And as many as she borrowed, Bible said the prophet told her, go into your closet, your room, lock the door and pour them. And she kept pouring and pouring till they got full. And when she asked the sons, that is there any other vessel? And the son said, no, there is no vessel. The oil did what? Seized. Hallelujah. The moment there is no empty vessel, the oil will not what? Be poured. When your heart is full, you don't expect God to come in. It doesn't matter what is full in your heart. I said when we gather, everybody has a heart condition. Somebody might be happy. Somebody might be sad. Somebody might be disturbed. Somebody might be worried. Somebody might be whatever. But that is not important. I came to tell you that anytime you go to God, make sure your heart is empty. Make sure you take out whatever and empty your heart and be ready to receive from God. When you empty your heart and you are ready to receive, He will always come in.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The oil you see is when the vessels are full. It doesn't matter what is in the vessel, but when the vessel is full, there will not be oil. Am I talking to someone? Let's read something in the book of Psalm 42. I like what David said there in the book of Psalm 42, verse 1 and 2. Psalm 42, 1 and 2. It's a song we sing mostly. Okay. It says what? As the what? Panted after what? The water brook. So panted my soul after thee, oh God. Verse 2. My soul thirsted for God, for the living God. When shall I come and appear before God? Hallelujah. My soul searched for you. My soul panted for you. Look, listen. When your heart is open, when your heart is empty, it pushes you to desire more. Amen.
Amen.
Whenever you are thirsty or you are hungry for God, it makes you look for God more. That is when you push yourself more. That is when you want God to come in the more. But when you come to Him or you go to God and you are full and you are satisfied, you don't yearn for Him. You don't need Him. Who is here who have ever been hungry before? Very hungry. And when you are, there is no food around. Hallelujah. Sometimes I tell myself, I will not eat late. I wouldn't eat. We'll come to church, we'll close church, I'll go home, I'll say I'll cry. Sometimes you'll be lying down. You know, kitty. Nobody will tell you, go and take the food. And when it happens like that, when you are eating, you don't think of it. You eat like somebody is chasing you. Hallelujah. Tell someone, be hungry for God. Say, thirst after God. Because that is what, you see, when you are hungry for God, when you are thirsting after Him, when you come and you empty your heart, you see, it shows. It shows. And you see, God is not looking at the way you are nicely dressed. God is not looking at, oh, you are sitting at a very nice place in church. God is not looking at, He's looking here. If God don't look at the heart, like He would have chosen Elijah or another person to be king of Israel, then God is always watching our hearts. Bible says that God does not see as what man sees. God looks at the heart. How is your heart? Is it empty or is it full? Right now as I am talking, how is your heart? Is your heart empty or is it full? Are you ready for God? Are you hungry for Him? Are you thirsty after Him? Are you ready that He will come in? He will only fill you if your heart is full. It's empty. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me end. I want us to pray. Come to Matthew chapter 5. When your heart is empty, you desire more of Him. When your heart is empty, you push more. When your heart is empty, you want Him to fill you. As the deer panted for the water brook, so my soul panted after you. So my heart is ready. So I am empty. So I open up. So I desire. Amen. We should always be empty whenever we go to Him. We should always be empty.
We should always be empty
and tell him, always tell him, fill my cup, fill my cup, fill my cup. Because when you fill him today, after some time when you go up, it will go down. You have to come and he will have to fill again. Amen. Matthew chapter 5, verse 6. I love that scripture. It's one of the Beatitudes. I call it beautiful attitude. Hallelujah. Can we read it together? I noticed something there. I don't know whether you have seen it. Blessed are they which do hunger and thirst. Hunger and thirst. Hunger and thirst. Hunger and thirst. Blessed are they who are always ready to say, God, fill me. Don't only fill me with food. Fill me with food and water. Let me be satisfied. Balanced my diet. Hallelujah. And he says, after righteousness, and this is where I want to hammer the last part. For what? Oh, for what? For what? Tell somebody, God will only feel emptiness. Tell somebody for me. Tell somebody, God will only feel emptiness. Yes, maybe you have good news, you are happy. You are in church, but your heart is full. It's full of joy. So you are not ready to hear from him. You are not ready to receive from him. Because you had good news, you are happy. Maybe you had bad news. Maybe something is worrying you. So you come, your heart is full of disturbances. Your heart is full of bad news. You are thinking about something bad. And so because of that, you are not ready to receive from him. But from today, I want to give you this key. That any time you come to God, no matter how it is, put everything aside. Remove everything. Empty your heart and say, God, I am ready. Not only to church, but any time you go to God, empty yourself. Because blessed are those who are hungry and are thirsty, and they shall be filled. When you get hungry and you are thirsty, it will fill you. But when you are already filled, it will bypass you. Close your Bibles and be on your feet. Empty your heart. Empty it. Empty it. Let the Lord know you are not ready to allow that thing to weigh you down. You are ready to receive from him. Help me to sing this song. Fill my cup, Lord. I lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsty of my soul. Bread of heaven, fill me till I want to do more. Fill my cup, fill it up, and make me whole. Oh, fill my cup, Lord. Advice and there should be a need that God needs to meet that need. No. I'm talking about emptying your heart. I'm talking about allowing God to fill your heart. I'm talking about telling God that, God, I want more of you. I need more of you. You see, if you do that every day, God will reveal himself in a different way. In a different way. In a different way. Then you keep knowing him more and more. Knowing him more and more. Hallelujah. Amen. And you see, when you do that, even if you have a need, then when he comes in, automatically, he settles that need for you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Close your eyes and lift up your two hands. And let us tell him to fill our bounds. Fill our bounds and let him flow. Fill my cup, Lord.
I need to have Lord.
Oh, come and quench
this thirst of my soul.
Our hearts are open. We are ready for you.